Hello friends, we will see documentation comment in Java. Now till now we have seen there are two types of comment. One is single line commenting and multi line commenting. This is called as single line commenting and this is multi line commenting in Java. One more type of comment is there which is called as documentation comment, and it is represented like this: slash star, after that again you will write star on each line, and at the end you will write star slash. This is called as documentation comment. Now what is the use of documentation comment? There is one tool which is called as JavaDoc. Now JavaDoc is a tool which comes with JDK and it is used to prepare documentation in predefined HTML format. So suppose if I am writing my class, in that class I am writing my methods. Now if this class is referred by someone else, then for that other user I want to provide some documentation, and for that purpose I will write a documentation comment in my class so that this JavaDoc tool will prepare the documentation for it which is used by some other person. Now in that documentation tag or other documentation comment, there are different tags predefined. So here one example is shown. You can see that this is the documentation comment from first line to the main method. In that they have defined tags like @author, @version, @since. These are the predefined tags, and the values which occur in front of those tags will go inside the HTML documentation created by JavaDoc at appropriate places. Which are the different tags we can use in documentation? @author means what? @author will give you the name of the author. Whichever name is written in front of that will be placed as a author. Then @code is there. It is used to indicate the code part of the documentation. Then docroot is there. Docroot will tell you where the corresponding documentation is stored, which is created by the JavaDoc tool. It will give you the relative path of that documentation. Then deprecated is there. Deprecated is used if some method is out of version. If it is no longer used, then you will declare that as deprecated. Few more tags are there. @exception. So if my class is throwing some exception, then the information about that exception is added to the documentation. @inheritDoc. If I have superclass and subclass, then if I want to inherit the comments of superclass, then I will make use of this tag inheritDoc. Then @link is there, @linkPlane is there, @param is there. If my method is taking some parameters, then the types of the parameters will be added to the param tag in the documentation. After that, @return will give you the information of the return value. @c is there. If I want to link multiple documentations, then I will make use of this tag. @serial, @serialData, serial field. @since. Since will give me the version from the current method or class is available. The remaining tags are throws tag is there. Throws is as good as exceptions tag. The job is same. @value is there. Suppose I have some static field in my class and that field is having some initial value and I want to mention that value in my JavaDoc, then I will make use of @value tag. @version will give you the version from which the current class or method is available. Now suppose I have a class which is adnum class and I am generating documentation for that class using JavaDoc tool, then the documentation file which is created is adnum.html. At the same time one more file will get generated, which is index.html. So here is an example where few important tags are used to create the JavaDocs. So the @author is used, @version, @since. On to the next slide. Class is written which is adnum class. Here the tags used are @param, @param. Now after this @param tags, the description is given. So that description will get added to the JavaDoc. After that adnum method is implemented, Then again main method is in next session. In main method I am creating the object and I am calling the method of that particular arnum class. So this was all about the Java docs in Java.